We head on up to a very, very fancy conference room, nice wood paneling, jerseys and trophies in the glass. And it was probably 15 members of the committee.
I'm up against a lot of doubters. I'm up against people who don't think that any of this holds any water.
By 2009, a new team had taken on the concussion issue. Boston University researcher Dr. Ann McKee was called by NFL doctor Ira Kasson.
I was called by Ira Kasson, and I remember thinking, why is Ira Kasson calling me?
She's intimidated from the start because she knew enough about Ira Kasson, she said, to know that he wasn't necessarily a friend.
And he wanted me to come to the NFL office and present the data.
That May, Dr. McKee and her colleague, Chris Nowinski, arrived at NFL headquarters.
We head on up to a very, very fancy conference room, nice wood paneling, jerseys and trophies in the glass. And it was probably 15 members of the committee.
And one of the first things McKee notices is that there's only one other woman in the room. And it's not a doctor, it's a lawyer.
A lawyer is not there to offer medical advice. And a lawyer is not there to offer competitive athletic advice either. A lawyer is there to figure out what the league needs to do to defend itself against a storm that may or may not come, but the league has to be ready to fight.
I'm up against a lot of doubters. I'm up against people who don't think that any of this holds any water. So fine, I'm just gonna show them what I have. They kept interrupting.
Dr. Ira Kasson and others on the committee expressed their skepticism that playing football was the cause of CTE.
Very, very quickly, she got serious pushback from Ira Kasson and the rest of the committee.
Indianapolis Colts team physician Dr. Henry Foyer was one of the NFL doctors at the meeting.
I just have a problem. Ann McKee, she cannot tell me where it's starting. We don't know the cause and effect. We don't know that right now. We don't know the incidents.
The committee members believe Dr. McKee could not answer two important questions. Causation, did football cause CTE? And prevalence, how many players had it?
She was seeing only those that were in trouble, and we know that there are thousands roaming around that are not having problems. So, you know, I think that's where we may have had an issue.
I think we're very early in the evolutionary understanding of CTE. A certain percentage of the individuals diagnosed with this have had steroid abuse, alcohol abuse, other substances abuses. We don't know the concussion history in many of these. And there may be other confounding factors in terms of the genetics that we simply don't understand.
They were convinced it was wrong. And I felt that they were in a very serious state of denial.
I remember at one point one of the NFL doctors asking, couldn't you be misdiagnosing this as, these all look like they could be frontal temporal dementia. And Ann said, well, actually I was on the NIH committee that defined how you diagnose that disease. So no, they're definitely different diseases. and it's like she had the experience and they didn't.
And according to Dr. McKee, there was something else. Something familiar about the way the NFL committee was acting.
I don't want to get into sexism too much, but sexism plays a big role when you're a doctor of my age who's come up in the ranks with a lot of male doctors. That's sexism's part of my life. And getting in that room with a bunch of males who already thought they knew all the answers, more sexism. I mean, it was like, oh, the girl talked. Now we can get back into some serious business.
I don't know why she feels that way. I thought that she presented herself, as I recall, and it's been several years, that there's something in her manner. And I think she's a brilliant woman. She's done a great job. There's just something just about the way she said it. And not that everybody was looking down. It was just...
Dr. Foyer insists Dr. McKee is mistaken about how she was treated.
If we, for some reason, came across as being disrespectful, then I would say that everybody else we interviewed over the 15 years must have felt the same way. That's all I can say about that. And I feel strongly about that, too. We would listen and thank you, and that's it. Whether she wanted us to start, I don't know where she's coming from on that.
The meeting had changed nothing.
My husband is a player who's severely disabled, and he can't be here right now.